This is so
I don't know
if it's nice to re-meet you.
Yeah.
It's been a while.
It's been a long time.
But how long is Boles?
Five. Yeah, okay, I was
good. We were just talking about being a 10 minutes ago.
Yeah.
Please stand for the entrance of the bride.
John and Kate, with our prayers and our love, as they are united in holy matrimony. Would you join me in prayer? Heavenly Father, we love you. We thank you for this day and for these moments of joy and celebration. Would you remind us that we are not mere witnesses of what you are about to do, but we are participants in what you are doing in the life of John and Kate. May you be our guest of honor. And may you be glorified by all that we say, do, and think. And it's in the name of Jesus that we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Who brings this woman to be married? You may be seated. So when John and Kate asked me to help them celebrate their day, I was really overjoyed. I've been a part of John's life for the past 2 or 3 years now. And when he started talking about Kate, and then there was the matter of when. They asked me to marry them, and then they told me the proposed date of the marriage, Halloween. I was a little taken back, but then I started to think, you know, marriage can be a wedding on Halloween is just the treat that we need, amen? And so today, just like all the other days in the calendar, It is the day that the Lord has made, and we will be glad and rejoice in it. So, Harry. And my 76-year-old father is very fond of saying to me nowadays that growing old work. I get couples that come to me, and they're regularly going through some difficult things. Sometimes I get retired couples coming to me and saying, we have a lot of time with each other now. What are we going to do? And so I remind them that marriage is hard, but marriage is worth it. The hardest thing that we ever voluntarily choose to do, marriage, is best designed to produce within us the best versions of ourselves. So I want to encourage those of you who may be sure, marriage is not so much designed to produce our happiness, although it can and does. Marriage really is best designed to produce holiness within us. You are broken and you are at some place of being put back together. So I want to encourage you to be kind to one another in the same way that God and Kate have not arrived at this moment, carried along on fluffy white clouds, listening to harp music and being fed grapes. That's not how they got here, right? John got here on a hayride, dealing with. They have not arrived in a pristine and perfect condition. They should not have felt under pressure to have arrived at this moment in a pristine condition. But they have one really great benefit and consolation. This moment, and Jesus is not yet your Lord and Savior. This is not going to be a long evangelistic message. I just want to say this. Give Jesus a chance. Because he is already very, very fond of you. There's oftentimes a misunderstanding about what marriage is and the pledges and the vows that are going to be made here. And it can lead to some heartache down the road. And so I want you to imagine, John, that you are holding in your hands Kate 3.0. That's not who you are marrying. You may like version 3.0. You may like version 3.0 better than 2.0. I don't know. But you hold in your hands and you are more versions of Kate. And the same thing for you. It is more than likely, we know, it's more than likely that you may not like John 13.1. In my counseling practice, they come and they say, you know, my wife doesn't look the same, and she doesn't act the same, she doesn't think the same things. I hardly even recognize the person that I married. And, you know, I have to say, you know, your wife is alive. Each other. That's the hard work, and that really is the great joy. So I want to just close this part of the message. If 2020 has taught us anything, it's that there's going to be a lot of alteration, a lot of change, a lot of curveballs coming from outside and from within us. But your love ought to be and can be an ever-fixed mark, which looks on tempests shaken. John should be your husband. I told you guys you were not just witnesses, you were participants. And so if you would please stand, I have a question for you. To enter, if so, please say, we will.
We will.
Will all those present please stand?
This is really just
an exercise to warm you guys up a little bit. Will you encourage and defend the marriage into which John and Kate are about to enter? If so, please say with a resounding, we will.
We will.
Let us pray together. Heavenly Father, you've heard the declarations of your people. You've heard our pledges. Help us to be faithful to what we have promised today. And may you get all the glory. We thank you and praise you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. So John and Kate have decided, rather than their the vows, by fasting their hands together. So let me ask you first, John, look into her eyes, not mine. You're not vowing anything. Kate, will you honor John as an equal partner in this union?
I will.
John, will you share in Kate's pain and seek to alleviate it?
I will.
Kate, will you share in John's pain, and there's probably going to be a lot of it, and seek to alleviate it? I always failed arts and crafts in school, so apologize. John's joy.
I will.
Mm-hmm. Alone.
I will.
Kate, will you share in John's burdens so that he will never feel alone?
I will.
And finally, John. Will you honor Kate with your unwavering fidelity today and all the rest of your days?
I will.
Kate, will you honor John with your And so the binding is made. Solomon writes this. He says that a threefold cord is not easily broken. And I like to think what he meant by that is that two of the cords are two people in partnership with each other. And the third cord is the presence and activity of God in the midst. We'll let God be the gold cord in the midst of this union. John, I do have a charge to you before we ask you to put this ring on your finger. This ring is fashioned in the shape of a circle, which can represent the never-ending never lives. And so I charge you with a memory I pray that you will never forget. This woman today, she stands by your side, not under your feet. I pray that you will remember that she is your helpmate, your corresponding strength. And I pray that you will always remember to submit to her as you revere what Jesus Christ has done for you and who he is in your life. So I ask you to take this ring.
In the Father,
and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Charge. This is the only ring left, so this is what we have here. So this ring is made of precious metal and can symbolize the purity of your love and how valuable true love is. But I also have to share with you that some wives have used this as an opportunity to dominate over their husbands as a gift from God our Father. This guy, he is your helpmate. He is your corresponding strength. Submit to him as you revere who Christ is and what he has done for you. Take this ring, the Son,
and
the Holy Spirit. I'd like to invite you all into an attitude of prayer as I pray just with the couple. I'm the only one crying up here. As a representative of Jesus Christ before Almighty God and in the power of the Holy Spirit, I now pronounce you husband and wife. John, you may kiss your wife.